He will forgive you. والله غفور رحيم. And Allah is forgiving and merciful. قل أطيعوا الله والرسول. Now here is إطاعة. Tell them you have to obey anyhow Allah as well as His Messenger. فَإِنْ تَوَلَّوْا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْكَافِرِينَ. And if they turn away, Allah doesn't like this kuffar. To refuse to obey Muhammad is kufr. So that is the basis. You have to obey him anyhow. Whether you like the order or command or not, you have to obey. This is the fundamental requirement of being a Muslim. But if you go higher, if you want to go higher up, then you see whatever he has been doing and you try to follow it, follow his example, that this is the higher level and that is called ittiba. إِنَّ اللَّهَ اصْطَفَى آدَمَ وَنُوحًا وَآلَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَآلَ إِمْرَانَ عَلَى الْعَالَمِينَ. We shall translate this next ayat in the next session, but please, the few minutes that we have, let me give you the introduction about these ayat now. I told you that the first half of this surah Al-Imran can be divided into three portions. The first portion ends at the ayah number 32 that we have completed. Second section is starting from ayah number 33 and it will go to ayah number 64, 31, 32 ayat. Now these ayat were revealed in the ninth year after Hijrah, very far off. The rest of the whole surah was revealed in the third year after Hijrah. But these 30 or more ayat, they were revealed in the ninth year after Hijrah. When a deputation of the ulama, of the knowledgeable person, people who were very high in hierarchy, religious hierarchy, of the Christians of Najran. Najran was a Christian colony on the southern side of Hijaz, and there the Christians were living. And from there, a deputation of their ulama and their high priests, they came to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the ninth year after Hijrah. And there was a dialogue. There was a dialogue about the beliefs of Islam. And you know, at that time these ayat were revealed. But they have been placed in this Quran, in Surah Al-Imran high, so that it should become similar to Surah Al-Baqarah. Because in Surah Al-Baqarah, the discussion was with the Jews. Ya Bani Israel, azkuru ni'mati allati anamtu alaykum. وَأَوْفُوا بِعَهْدِي أُوفِ بِعَهْدِكُمْ وَإِيَّايَ فَارْهَبُونَ. Here this is the second individual of the pair. The pair, you know, of Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah Al-Imran. And you know, the other group of Ahle Kitab is the Christians. So here in the Surah Al-Mubarakah, the discussion regarding the Christians and their beliefs, that has been placed here, although it was revealed much later than the rest of the Surah Al-Imran. So here, you know, we'll find very good discussion about who Jesus was, what was his real position, who was Mary, and actually then the parallel case of Hazrat Yahya alayhi salatu wasalam, Hazrat Zakariya. All these things we find also in the Makki Quran in Surah Al-Maryam. But here, you know, special occasion, you know, that demanded that these things should be in a fresh way, they should be discussed when those people came for discussion and dialogue and argument with Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So these ayat were revealed in the ninth year after Hijrah, and we shall study them in the next session, inshallah. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Quran al-Azim wa nafa'ani wa iyyakum bil ayati wa zikr al-hakim.
Allahu akbar.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about Iona, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.